Monday. I've had a lie-in this morning. Saying that, it's like 10:04. I'm like, wow, a lie-in. I think I stayed in bed until 8:30, maybe. I don't know how to lie in anymore. I don't enjoy it. It'll get to 12 o'clock and I've done fuck all. I'll be like, that's half my day gone. Just got to the gym. My pre is just kicking in. I'm going to train legs today, I believe. Got the pussy pad 3000, as Andy christened it when he gave it to me, which was kind of weird, but we roll with it. Gonna get hip thrusting and all things glutes and hams, I believe. We'll double check, but yeah. I honestly, at the minute, I forget what day it is, so I am just like, I don't know what I'm training today. I don't know what because I have no concept of what day it is at the moment. I don't think that's a prep thing. I think that's just a life is going by very quickly thing and not really sure what's going on. Got loads to do all the time. I think I'm just busy as fuck. They all roll into one. So gonna do that. Gonna go and get some shopping. I might show you my shopping haul because for some reason we like looking at that. That's no shade to anyone. I also like looking at what people are buying from the supermarket. It's that part of getting older. This morning I unpacked my new heated aerer and was like buzzing over it. So I'm quite content with getting older. This week is gonna be a lot more chill, thank fuck. Just normal stuff, see how it goes. And this Sunday we've got another posing seminar with NFM, which will be good. Although they're having a barbecue and I can't eat that. So I'm just gonna probably linger around it and sniff it. Nothing new here. Session was long and I've not eaten a lot. Oh, I don't even know what time I got there, but it's now 10 to 1. Pretty sure it's about 10:30. I love taking my time. A lot of the time I don't get a chance to do that, but it's great when you can. Andy's gonna lose his fucking mind. I've bought more protein puddings, but I just, you know what? It's worth the argument. It's worth the argument. I'm gonna show you what I got from Aldi. I'm gonna have to get these away before Andy sees them and realizes that I've accumulated more, so bear with me. Okay, please ignore the washing machine in the background, but we've got all the standard stuff. P
peanut butter, mixed veg, normal veg. I always stick to broccoli when I'm being given green veg. My mince, chicken. This was like $11.99 for 2 kilos, which I thought was really good value. Standard. Hold on a moment. Right. Obviously, this is post-show or when almond butter is returned into my plan. But toffee apple flavour, okay. Going to give this a try because it's obviously a dupe for the Nivea. I think it was like £1 something, so going to give that a go. Bit obsessed with these at the moment. I got the raspberry one the other day. I measure it out to about 5 grams to put in my porridge in the absence of the Nutella. And these are pretty much the same as the ones that I recommended from Morrison's. However, they've got an apple flavour. Apple is my favourite, flavoured thing. And orange and summer fruits. Otherwise, they're pretty much the same, but they sucked me right in. I think they're 2 calories per... Sorry, that was very aggressive. 2 calories per icy pole. So, whilst the weather is still nice, I'm going to load up on those bad boys. So, yeah, I was quite impressed with that. Obviously, my protein puddings are put away. See whether he notices. He doesn't watch my vlogs because he's like, why would I? I live it. Okay. This is a bit of a weird one for me. And you've got Paula to thank for this. So one of my subscribers, Paula, sounds so weird saying I've got subscribers, because I just can't imagine anyone watching this, asked me to do like a very quick makeup tutorial. Now, and I'm not lying, look at the comments on my last video, someone asked me to do a makeup tutorial. And I feel like I have actually perfected the like 5 minute face for when I'm just not giving a fuck. I have been wearing next to no makeup at all throughout this prep, actually, for work and things like that. All I really, really wanted at the start of this prep was to find like a product that was my skin but better that I could just chuck on. It took me a while to find it, a few different attempts at stuff, and I finally have. And it's with thanks to one of my best friends, Jess. It is the Laura Mercier Tinted Moisturiser. This is the oil-free one, but there is another one because I picked it up in Mexico. Oh no, this is also oil-free. Oh, well, there is. I have oily skin, so I like to keep things relatively matte if I can help it, and oil-free. So this is my starting off skin. I have got microbladed eyebrows, and that was a choice that I made because I did envision myself wearing less makeup going forward, and my eyebrows was always something that I would rather have had, because actually I have very, very sparse eyebrows, and you can see that when I'm right up close. Now, they do look darker in person, but I actually recently had them topped up. And if you do go for that and you have oily skin like me, which is mainly here on my nose, do a dry healing. Don't wet them. Don't be putting Vaseline on them. Go for dry healing and see how you get on. So I'm actually going to time this, because how low maintenance is this? So I'm going to start a little timer, my watch. And I'm going to use the products that I would use if I was just doing a very quick, I want to get out of the house, but I want to look a little bit like I've made an effort. So I don't even know whether this is going to be the right colour for me at the moment, because I've got a little bit of tan on. Actually, this is kind of a little bit of tanny. I don't know. Right, I'm waffling now. So I will talk through the products I'm going to use as I do it. And this is probably going to be the worst thing that you've ever seen. If you're a makeup artist, please just look away, because you're going to hate me. But I'm starting it now. So this is Laura Mercier Tinted Moisturiser in nude. There are people screaming right now. Screaming. What are you doing? A little goes a long way with this stuff. So just a little bit of freshening. And then I'm using the Too Faced Chocolate Matte. I'm just gonna do a little bit of something here. I mean, towards the arse end of prep, you probably don't want any contour, but I just warm up areas of my face that I feel like I need it. And then I'm using the e.l.f. Wow Brow in Deep Brown. And I'm just putting a little bit through my eyebrows. So this for me is like a, I'm not wearing makeup at all. And then what I tend to do, I'm gonna go in with a very, very old MAC. I think this is Peach Melba, but I couldn't tell you because it's so old. Barely use any blush, really. Oh, that's probably too much. I literally do just have a little, this is like summer skin, I think. No, I'm by no means good at makeup, but I mean, if you wanted to leave it there, I don't feel like you really need to go for any mascara because it is just literally a hello. This is still my face. I've recently been using the Huda. It's like a 2-in-1. And I'm gonna go a lot lighter on this than I normally would because I don't want it to be loaded eyelashes and then not a lot of anything elsewhere, so I am literally just brushing a brush through them. Probably not going to put any on the I'll put a little bit on the bottom. I mean minimal on the bottom. And that is my 3 minute 3 minute 32 seconds face. So Paulie, welcome. I hope that was enlightening. I'm going to work. Wanna look less dead, but not altogetherly giving a fuck. And that's it. That is all I do on days where I am trying to do a little bit of something. If I'm honest, at the moment, if I'm trying to, I've got three levels of skin at the moment. I've got couldn't give a fuck, which is this. I've got two, which is using the ordinary products, which is like, I'm making a little bit of an effort, but I'm not really sure what I'm doing. And then if I was going full beat, like I did for Pride, I would be wearing Estee Lauder Double Wear. And trying to do something with that. I wear that in several different shades and I mix them because I'm a heathen. And like I said, there's probably makeup artists that just want to punch me in the face, but that is what I do. And I've only actually just graduated to putting it on with a makeup sponge because again, I'm trash and I used to use just my fingers. So I used to be somebody that wore a lot of makeup and sat down and really got into it. I still can. I just find it a bit difficult at the moment because I've been wearing so little. When I sit down and do that, I feel like some sort of fucking imposter and that I've gone too far because I'm like, there's so much on my face. I haven't been doing that at all this year. I haven't really got the time and I just can't be asked. And I also don't want to. I've been really happy with how I look. I've just been really happy with myself. I've respected my body and what it's doing. And whilst I've not been wearing makeup, my skin's been quite good. So I've just been happy with how I look without it and just looked at myself in the morning and gone, oh, yeah, cool. If I've had like events and stuff or things to do with work, just been doing a bit of that.
I don't think I'll actually go back to using much else now, to be honest. But yeah, that took me 3 minutes and 30 seconds. So I'm quite happy with that. ignore my sock hair. These are elite. The ones that I showed you before were purely just for something cold and hitting the spot of something cold. These actually have a lot of flavour. 2 calories. That tastes like Apple Tango, and that's my favourite. Aldi. Three, two, three. I've still got to go out for my walk yet. Just having my second chicken and rice meal of the day. I'm following my check-in this morning. Will probably be the last time I have the rice in this meal. It's just going to make most of it. I'll give you a full update when I go out for my walk. Update on my check-in. Not enamoured. Wasn't very happy with it this morning. My weight hasn't really changed and I've plateaued. The inflammation around my midsection is back. And just, it's so annoying because it's not a waste of time because the output is still the same and somewhere along the line there will be a big drop. But it just makes you feel like, what's the point? Like it doesn't want to give. So I think I've lost all my rice on a rest day now, and I've lost about 180 grams of rice on a training day, I think. That's cooked weight, obviously. I'm not a monster. So I haven't had a look at it in great detail yet, but that's what it's looking like. So that's that. My cardio has been increased from half an hour to 45 minutes. Yep. That will alter things a little bit. Just annoying. What else did I have to say? Oh, I went into my junk folder to see if I'd had a reply from a wedding supplier and found an invitation to the NABBA Universe because I've qualified for that. Okay, annoyingly it's on the 5th of November and I've got too much going on. End of October, I've got my best friend's 30th, I've got my birthday and I just want to be able to enjoy them. So I think once finals are done, that's it for me. I've done a lot of shows this year and I'm happy with what I've achieved. And I think it's time to start implementing some of the advice and feedback and beef the fuck up, you know. Just was surprised to see that. And a little bit annoyed that it isn't like 3 weeks earlier. Never mind. Ooh. Cardio done. Just did half an hour. I did 15 minutes this morning. How weird that I was just about to say, you know, I'm not actually feeling the hit of losing the rice out of one of my meals yet, and my stomach just went. Sorry, did we arrange that? No. It's weird because it makes you feel a little bit nervous that I'm not feeling hungry yet. Should I? Shouldn't I? I don't feel too bad. And I haven't been feeling hungry up until right this moment. Stomach's still going. It's about 6:10. I'm gonna go and grab a little bit of shopping from Lidl and get home and have a shower because it's fucking rank out here. It's so hot, it's so hot in there. Why is no one sorting the aircon out here? Fuck. People are staring at me across the car park like, why are you talking to yourself? Talking to my friends, bitch. Look at my little nub, by the way. What a nice bun that is. Don't look like a Teletubby at all. Great. Right, off to Lidl to go and get some yogurt and nanas and some micellar water because I've run out.
Hello, it's Thursday, which is my first rest day that I've taken midweek for a couple of weeks because I've just had shit going on at the weekend. And it's my first rest day with like a significant drop of food in it. Rest days have been usually swapping my oats breakfast with the banana and the protein powder for some beef and broccoli. Yana. And I've been having that. And my other meals have been kind of like as normal. However, there's no rice today. And I have been feeling the hunger. Not hunger. We ain't there yet, but yeah, I woke up this morning and I was like, ooh, this is gonna sting me a little bit. And safe to say, it has been noticed that there's just not as much food. I might bring forward my, I used to have that oatmeal in the afternoon whilst I was at work, the second one, and I might do that again today. Might bring that back. Wow. But then it does just leave me my protein pudding and my rice cakes to have later on. So I'll try not to, but it's always there in the arsenal, I guess. It's 20 to 2. Getting some steps in. It is hot. It is hot, my guys. Glad I got my cardio out of the way this morning so I don't have to go back there. I'm so close to finishing this first assessment for my coaching qualification. So I can spend some time on that this evening and get that done before the weekend, hopefully. Then Andy can check it before I submit it. Now, I think it's getting more and more, I don't think anything's completely confirmed yet, but it's looking more and more likely that Andy's going to the USA for a few weeks now. And it's looking like it might happen as early as next week. So that's a bit gutting. Also, it's our anniversary today. And neither of us remembered. That's the first time that's ever happened. I feel fucking terrible. I don't want to be that couple. We've just got so much going on at the minute. And I think because now we've got engaged and we're like planning the wedding and planning the wedding, we just kind of forgot about that one and we were like, shit. We always prefer to celebrate the day that we met anyway, which we did whilst we were in Mexico. So that was kind of cool. God, get me back to Mexico. Fuck this shit. Good morning, it's Friday. I got really excited last night preparing my pineapple and then double checked my plan and it's not in there anymore. So I'm just about to make my pre-workout meal. Still a bacon with jam, and it's been about 150 grams of yogurt and a 30 gram scoop of protein. I did an Insight subs order the other day, and in the previous order that I did, they forgot to put in a sample of something that I wanted to try. They still charged me for it. And they're like, hey, did you enjoy your order? I was like, I did, but a bit of it was missing. And they were like, oh shit, let us know when you order from us again and we'll chuck in some little bits, which I thought was really cool. They're a really nice company. I really like them. If you don't order from them, this is what they look like. Get me one of these. They sent me a supplement needs sample. They sent me a CMP birthday cake whey sample. And they sent me this, which I've not heard of before, which is Reflex Nutrition. I'm gonna try that in the yogurt this morning. I don't know how it's gonna go. It's a 30 gram serving, so it's perfect. What I actually ordered was just some chocolate CMP, because I wanted to try it again. I haven't tried the chocolate one that's on its own. I've only ever tried the salted caramel and the biscoff and the cereal milk. So I wanted to try this one. And the deal that they've got on at the moment, you got an EAA sample for free, which is 10 servings. So Love that for me. I might try that today too. Yummy, yummy. Lots of things to try. I've got a check-in tomorrow. I am feeling a little bit... Well, are we getting anywhere? I think my friend Molly is also feeling that. Her coach is kind of saying, you know, if things don't start going anywhere soon, might have to pull it. I'm just hoping that I've got a bit of... It's made me a bit nervous for my check-in tomorrow. Hoping that I've got somewhere. I certainly, yesterday, felt like we were getting somewhere. Last night was the first night in a long time that I went to bed and I'm like, I'm hungry. So that's good. It's not good, but it is good if you're one of these weirdos that symbolises hunger when things are working in the right direction, I suppose.
Ooh, that smells really sweet.
CMP is a really, really fine way. It always looks more than it is, I think, anyway. Right, here we go. Birthday cake whey and yogurt. It's made that very, very thick, which isn't a bad thing. Tastes a bit cake battery, but it's lost its sweetness in yogurt, I think. It doesn't taste how it smells in yogurt. So I think maybe that is one for porridge or a shake or drizzled on top of something, as a lot of people tend to do. I don't really get that. I'm just not one of those people. I wish I was. I was trying to get on the cream of rice hype and I made some up when I won that competition, and to me it just tasted like chocolate mashed potato. But I don't know whether that was my technique, and I could not understand why everybody was banging on about it. I couldn't even finish it. I just got myself in a hole. I came in here looking for the cold brew unsweetened, just black of that, because I've got some of the vanilla coffee creamer from Skinny Food, and I was going to try and make myself a nice iced coffee. There is nothing more that I want right now. In one of these. I haven't really had a craving hit at all yet, but I'd love a nice coffee. Let's try somewhere else. I just got really excited about finding the Relentless Peach drink, and then I got ID'd and I don't have any on me, so that's the way today's gonna go. Are you joking? Under 25? You seen these valleys? No, I'm sorry. She was on a power trip. Saturday morning, I'll have just put my check-in in there for you to see. I'm just a bit indifferent about how I look. My weight hasn't changed. It's just taking its time to come off. I'm not gonna read too much into it. Jenna worries about that, not me. We're just gonna get on with getting on and doing what I need to do. So it is disheartening when your weight doesn't come down, because especially after a couple of weeks, because the pressure's on. But I don't need to worry about it too much. My body has done that before where it's not dropped any weight, and then all of a sudden there's a big drop and it gets on its way. So it'll come, and she's not changing anything going into next week. So see how we go. Andy and I are going to go and train, then we're going to go to the beach, the summer holidays on a Saturday. I'm sure we'll be fine. We've said before that we wanted to make an extra effort to go and do non-preppy things, so that's what we're doing. We're going to the beach, I'm going to play on some 2p machines. I'm going to smell everybody's donuts. Is that right?
That's right.
What are you going to win on the 2p machines today?
Jurassic Park bouncy ball.
Oh my god, yeah, that happened.
Where is that? Have you kept it? Bet not.
I don't think it made it when we moved in.
Are you serious?
It might be in my memory box.
That's the first ever gift I gave to you.
Andy, the first gift you gave to me was love. I couldn't even take myself seriously.
It was actually a bite of my double stack.
No, that was the night he told me he loved me.
Yeah.
And that's what did it. Andy had a French stack and he gave me the last bite of his McDonald's French stack. And he told me he loved me shortly after. And I was like, I know, I could tell you gave me your French stack. Anyway, we're going to the beach. Andy's going to suck at 2p machines and probably get some. I'll watch you eat chips. The living room looks very green.
Got news for you.
I know it is green,
yeah.
But it looks really green on here. Anyway, that was exciting for you. That's the day. Go train.
Go train.
Fuck off, he's a prick. I'm going to do my cardio when I get back and split it up a bit. Otherwise, we'll be there for forever. So. Andy's hip mobility freaks me out. I can't do that.
Gone. On, two more. Go on, last one. Push, 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 push.
How's the chippy chips?
Delicious.
Don't you choke on them. Bad, is it?
Skag Vegas.
Mm.
Yeah, it's all right.
It's
all right. Says the best.
Yeah. Gamble responsibly.
Absolute skills. I think it is it.
What was it? Don't know.
What?
I want it. We're down to the bones now. It's right there. Two things. I'm on duty today and I've obviously been at the beach and we've had two massive field fires, so that's not wicked. So I'm just filling in the paperwork for them. I finally realized why I keep getting this black mark down my face. It's because I keep spraying my roots on and like putting my glasses or my sunglasses here and then moving them back down my face and getting a black line on my nose. Honestly, that's been a mystery for like 2 weeks and I've been like, why is this happening? Stupid woman. Sometimes smart, but sometimes just not. So, oh, on the other, I'm not so smart thing, said I was going to go back to the gym, didn't I, and do my cardio. I forgot it shuts at 6 on a Saturday. So tomorrow, after the NFM workshop, I have an hour and a half's cardio to do. Now, this happened in my last prep, and I said it'd never happen again because I don't like begging and borrowing from another day at all. I boxed the day off, and I've done my steps, I've done my cardio. I don't borrow from another day. And I think in the last one, I watched Spider-Man, and I just did it on the cross trainer and did a full 90 minutes on the cross trainer. Well, tomorrow we're back. What will I watch tomorrow? I feel like it's not going to be another Marvel film. Don't know. But here we are. Fires, fires, fires. Roll on next week when we've got thunderstorms to worry about. Six pump field fire. Blah, 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 no action. Yep, yep, yep. I hope I'm going to have a quiet night, but I've got a feeling. No, no, no. Hello. Again, you've got Paula to thank for this one. I'm going to the NFM posing workshop today because they've got, for posing workshops, it just has to make a little bit more effort. 9 times out of 10, they've got a photographer there, and just don't know. I'm just going, look at that. I've shown you 3 minute face. I'm now going to show you what I think is probably about 10 minute face. Time it again. I'm enjoying these. You're probably not, but I'm having a good time. Oh God, no, that's the camera. I'm so old. So this was going to be very, very similar to before, but I'm going to time it anyway. Okay, so. Same concept. Just a little bit more coverage on the base. I don't really know what colour or what shape my face is at the moment. So what I used to tend to do when I was wearing heavier coverage is I'd buy double wear in the shade Desert Beige or Shell, depending on whether I'd tanned or not. And then I would pick up a couple of the ordinary foundations because they're only about fiver. And I just mix them in because they're supposed to be a good dupe for double wear. Now, I don't like a match at the moment, but I'm going to style it out with some shade, don't you worry. And then I'm going to put a little bit of concealer under my eyes. Down my nose. A little bit of that, a little bit of that. Back to the beauty blender. I'm just gonna do this. Again, there's not a lot of skill involved in this. There's watching people do it properly and go, yeah, I'll have a stab at that. And then I'm gonna use the number 7 translucent powder just to set that. This used to come with a powder puff and now it doesn't, and it's very inconvenient because I used to just chuck this in my handbag for anything and everything. I've tried loads of different powders in my life. Always come back to number 7. It is one of the best. Fight me. And then I'm gonna do what I did in my 3:38 face. And just warm up some of those areas with the Too Faced chocolate matte. So it doesn't matter that my face was slightly lighter because I'm going to warm it through. Yeah, they're really, I am not paying a lot of attention to where I'm putting stuff, which is why I still think this is a very basic makeup look. I don't think this, it looks dark on the compact, but I think it's too bad. Now it's starting to look a little bit more like it's my shade. Use the Iconic palette again and just use the peachy coloured Bellini as a blush. I'm gonna go over here, use this. Too much, I can't tell. Probably. And then on top of that, I'll put the Becca highlighter, but I'll give myself some eyebrows first. And it is the same shit, different day. Elf in deep brown. I have to take some makeup remover with me as well because
nobody wants to be wearing makeup when they're doing 90 minutes cardio. Oop. And what I'm going to do differently today with this is that I'm just going to define them a little bit more, because I've got more of a base on. I feel like I probably ought to define them a little bit. Surprise, surprise, I'm going to go back to the Iconic palette, because I wanted to kind of show you how versatile it was. I think it's a really good purchase. I mean, I didn't purchase it, but it was gifted. And not like YouTube gifted, like my friend gave me a gifted. God, we're not there yet. Will we ever be? Who knows? You've got to start somewhere, right? I do really enjoy making these videos. So if you have got to this point and you're not subscribed, please do, because it excites me every time I get another one. Every time I get another one, I'm like... And I do think off-season will be interesting. There's a lot to be learned in off-season. Also, with Emily going away for 3 weeks, I might actually get those sit-down videos filmed that I keep promising and don't deliver on. I don't want to be that person. And what should they be? I was going to do like a things I've learned in my first prep, tips and hacks. What else was I going to do? There was a couple of more that I thought of that escaped me now. And then I'm just going to not give much of a shit which brush I'm using, because I'm just not that good. And I've picked up Morphe palette. This was only £12.50. That just looked like I've put too much on, but I promise in person it's not actually that bad. This is £12.50. I picked this up when I went to go and see Lady Gaga from Stratford. Is it Westfields? I can't remember. It was £12.50. These normally retail at £28 to £35, I think. Worth picking it up, even if you only like a couple of colours. It's quite basics and shimmers, pretty much. Yeah, if ever there's a Morphe palette on sale, like, I'm off to a flame, baby. And I'm just using the shade, what shade is that? Unisex, I think. I'm just packing it on. Not much of a care in the world. It's a bit peachier than just some of the other neutral shades I use, because I wanted it to go with the blush. She's got no skills. I used to watch a lot of tutorials and really try and recreate them, but who has the fucking time? It's just not that good anymore. So I pretty much do the same thing over and over, unless I am going somewhere and I've specifically sought something out, like a makeup look that I want to do. And then I'm just packing a couple of the darker neutrals in my crease. And that's probably where we'll leave it, to be honest. I might use a little... I don't know whether I can bother to line them a bit. I don't think I can. Quite enjoying this pretty natural look. What time are we on? 9 minutes, 10 seconds. Not bad, you know. Any eyelash curling should be taken off my total time, because it just takes ages, doesn't it? I'm going to use a brand new one for these. Using the Huda Beauty Legit lashes again, and I go in with the volume side first. Am I kidding? I need this here. This mascara is so good. I have really long eyelashes, but I think this mascara is the tits for all. Keep buying it in the little tube, because I always get scared that mascaras are going to dry out. And also, the little tubes last me about 6 months. So I always get it in like the tester size. Let's be honest, mascaras are expensive as fuck nowadays. As you get older and you can spend more, it doesn't mean you should fuck yourself over. Yeah, I think there's always a risk with mascaras that they'll dry out, so I always buy the smaller one. And it costs half the price. I just got into a habit of buying the tester sample of things because I was testing them. It's just very convenient. You'll never see me buy a full-size mascara. Okay. Pretty much done. I mean, I've made a little bit of a mess where my mascara is printed on my eyelid, so what I might do is just buff some of that eyebrow shade, along the bottom and make it look like I meant to do that. And that is pretty much it, I reckon. I'm gonna put a bit of Becca on, seeing as we went to such great lengths to get it. And then, come actually going out, I'll probably put a little bit of Libby on, but I've not been doing anything that crazy. I've literally just been using like a, this is probably a go-to, Revolution matte in Chauffeur is a standard for me. It's very much like the Kat Von D Ludwig, but cheaper, which used to be my like staple shade. So, just a bit pinkier, glowier, a little bit more coverage. And that is, oh, I feel like I should be allowed a little bit more time because of faffing. But that is the 14 minute 34 makeup look.
You start doing it, the more you pull into you, stretch your throat, so trying to keep posture upright as well, whilst also, instead of sitting in either, you want to almost like, as silly as it sounds, like lift and bring round, like that's what you need to focus on when you're doing the pose, like literally like I'm like lift and bring round, rather than sitting. And obviously you want your new section looking really small as well, so it's kind of
trying
to get it
together.
You might not even have a crazy
face that side of
legs, but if you can bring the ratios involved in it, it'll look like that's it. Because honestly, I've like seen Velvet's girls on like stages like that. Look at this, even person, I'm like,
show off.
Like, the tiny
steps.
It brings that crazy.
Hold that
though. Naturally, this super.
Should we be holding this?
Crazy mouth.
Head judge might be going around at this point. We're going to say, right, we're going to do our other poses. We're going to do front double bicep. So I'm here.
Back on that leg.
Step.
Yeah.
Step.
And then like
bring the arms up. We can either come up the body and step, or all the way around and on top of the head. So you've got to bring that down.
Back pauses.
Bring the feet together. This time, instead of going around to the side, we're doing a knee shot.
Which is obviously like
we're going to set up straight to the back. So it's like one leg.
Start
the other leg behind. Do it like the floor. And again, arms up.
So it doesn't mean like, say for example, the whole time you're doing like this, but you could essentially
from there, you're going to hear favourite side tricep. So just like transition out of that,
you can
like slide that leg out, and then you're going to go into either those positions.
But you, the criteria and the rules are to have air off that.
You can play around with kind of how your glute pops.
This does look nice.
And then we can hear favourite side chest. So if you're turning around all the way to the other side, I'm going to step back, I'm going to come all the way around the corner, I'm
going
to switch legs and then slide into that chest position.
Pause.
Good.
then go around. So yeah, it's just
and then
just
the more that you can do that as well. So yeah, the actual. So you're just gonna slide that back in.
And once again,
two steps.
No, but obviously I do want to work for your physique as well, and it does naturally look
better. Good. And then last but not least, it might shout.
Let's say go back into your first side.
Figure.
And we're gonna do removing hair and popping that ball. Just to get
from there, we're just gonna go into your favourite, so, wherever that is. Let's give it a
round and cut off.
And then when they say relax, that does not mean relax, that means come back
to that. Pause.
Then from there, that's it. Thank you very much. Either head off stage or head to the back of the stage.
And then you can press that.
Have you got any tips
for bed?
In terms of the walk itself, like feet wise, it's kind of dependent on the person. I won't try walking on the line, so like this,
it's not on the criteria to
place, it's got these lines that you've walked on. You know when you go out take with your walk, and naturally then that's going to come a little bit more in this way you step and things like that.
I wish I'd heard that about you.
That's cool. That's their choice, their priorities, that this is yours, and you've got to own it that little bit more.